What is it you want to know? Say it for the camera.
Can you show me? Can you show me where it says? Read it out.
The word Jizya. Because if you're not mistaken, it's number 88, yeah? 88. Sorry.
Okay. Sahih al-Bukhari. Can you zoom in? Sahih al-Bukhari.
It's too bright, but anyway.
So
Sahih al-Bukhari
then. Sahih al-Bukhari is there. Are you going to zoom in?
I'm going to put it on the screen. Can you see it? Take a picture of it. Oh, the cover. Okay, hold on.
You can put the cover then.
That's the cover, but the page I'm going to go to.
Sun is rocking. I didn't know that kind of
person. You can brighten it.
Why?
You want me to go like that?
The main thing is that Ali Dawah can see
it. Oh, you can just put it there. See, if you had his number, you can put it there. You're not going to be able to see it.
Yeah, you can see it. I can see it from here. Sorry. Narrated even that the Prophet said, my livelihood is under the shadow of his vision. He who disobeys my orders. Sorry, yeah. Narrated Ibn Umar that the Prophet said, my livelihood is under the shed of my spear, and he who disobeys my orders will be humiliated by paying the jizya. This chapter is from Sahih al-Bukhari, the one I quoted last week, 5588. So you said it doesn't say jizya, it's right there.
Can you check the Arabic?
Can you read Arabic?
Yeah.
Well, this guy, he can't even read Arabic.
Yeah, I can't read.
That's it, debate is done.
I can't see the word jizya.
Brother, the word jizya is right there.
One second, that's it. I'm trying to look in Arabic. Yeah, one second, I'm trying to find the word jizya.
I don't understand. It's been translated.
One second. I need, because the thing is, I looked into the same thing in Arabic, we couldn't find the word jizya, yeah?
Basically, we are checking what Sahih al-Bukhari said, what Muhammad said in Sahih al-Bukhari about humiliation by paying the jizya. And he's saying it does not say jizya. I showed him that it says jizya clearly. He wants to go to the Arabic and check if it says jizya.
But also no, check
the people that translated it from Arabic to English.
What about this?
He should go to them. They don't want to put jizya.
Okay, one second. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to check just another source. Yeah? Because the Sahih Bukhari you have, just not that saying made it up. I'm just going to double check.
I don't have time to write Sahih Bukhari. Trust me.
No. What? Give me the reference, please. Okay. Give me the one. What is it?
56.
Sahih al-Bukhari, book 56, 88, book of jihad. We are talking about, again, last week's topic. Ali Dawah didn't have enough, I guess. He came back. But today will be the end, because we can't be talking about the same topic over and over again. I've already proved the point.
You never talked about me.
In Surah 929, it says they have to pay jizya to be humiliated. Jews and Christians.
That's what
we're going to
talk today.
Very clear. And then Ibn Kathir.
That's what we're going to debate today.
The Battles of the Prophet, page 183, 184. Khalili says jizya payment has to be made by Jews and Christians under Islamic State, otherwise they should be killed. Sahih al-Bukhari clearly says jizya payment will be for humiliation. Muhammad clearly said that.
Humiliate.
It's very clear. I can't show you any more clearly.
Humiliate those who are attacking us, 100%.
It doesn't say that.
Definitely.
So Ali Dawah is writing Surah 929
okay.
on his own.
What I'm going to do is now.
Surah 929 says, fight those who don't believe in Allah.
Okay.
But in Ali Dawah's version of the Quran, okay. it says, fight those who are attacking
you. It's not the Bible.
So we have to read Ali Dawah version of the Quran.
The word jizya does not exist. It's not there. Yeah. My point is not that. Look, we don't have an issue with the jizya. It's just about the word jizya is not there. It's not there.
No, no.
It's not there.
You came today to say the word jizya is not there. Okay. So jizya is the problem.
It's not there. No, it's not the problem.
Listen, people will be humiliated by paying the khalafa. Is that what you're saying?
No, no, I'm not saying khalafa.
Does it say, what is that word?
No, humiliated by paying.
By paying what?
But it doesn't say, the word Jesus doesn't exist there.
Okay, well, what do you pay then? Tell me.
But let's say, look, argument's sake, if I said to you, for example, the key thing that you're looking for is the humiliation, yeah? So that's the key that you're saying is humiliation. Yeah, because as long as...
Jizya? And okay. humiliation. They're okay. both key,
bro. What I'm saying is, look, let's suppose argument says the word jizya is not there. But argument's sake, let's say, you know what, no problem. For humiliation, they need to pay jizya. No problem. Now let's discuss it, yeah? Okay. What we want to do is, I want you to put your premise and say, Ali, this is what my premise is. I want you to tackle that and I'm going
to... I don't want you to be like Adnan like last week. Ask me for my premise 3-4 times and then you're not listening to my premise.
Okay, you
I've already told you. The premise was Jews and Christians pay jizya as a sign of humiliation.
Okay.
Yeah? I showed you Surah 929. I gave you Ibn Kathir. And I gave you Sahih al-Bukhari, Book 55, Chapter 88. Yeah? Fighting Jihad. It's very clear. Who's smoking weed? Anyway, it says paying jizya. So if you're saying it's not jizya, what is that word? Tell me what that word is.
No, I'm saying the word jizya doesn't exist there.
What is it then?
But even
what is it then? If it's not jizya, what is it?
Okay, let me know when you finish that.
No, I'm asking you a question.
Okay, let me answer that. So the thing is, the word jizya is not in there. But for argument's sake, we'll go with what you're saying, yeah? Is that the Prophet peace be upon him is saying that they will be humiliated by paying jizya. No problem. It doesn't exist there, but for the argument's sake, let's go with it. Is your premise that we have to humiliate the Jews and the Christians and we do that by getting jizya?
Yes.
Okay, good. So what we're going to do is we're going to see if this statement is true or not. Simple. Is that fair?
Go. Show me what you want to show me.
All right, good.
Because so you can't get better than Ibn Kathir, Sahih al-Bukhari, and the Quran.
The sun is out.
So you're saying you can get better than the Quran, Sahih al-Bukhari, and Kathir, Ibn Kathir.
What we're going to do now is, we're going to debunk the premise of that by default, that we should attack the Christians and the Jews, and we should humiliate them by asking the jizya. Okay, so what we're going to do is, this is the issue that we're going to talk about, yeah? And this is mentioned in Surah Toba, verse 9, chapter 9, verse 29. Okay.
29. You can read the context from 28 to 32.
So what we're going to do is this, yeah?
Still okay. says the same thing.
No problem, yeah? So what we're going to do is this. First, let's make it very clear. Okay, let's make it very, very clear. Now, when it comes to paying jizya, okay, the Prophet, peace be upon him, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he implemented this, and the other khilafas, yeah, who implemented this, the khalifs, that who has to pay for it? Number one, it's the military, number one. Point number one that we need to distinguish is that the jizya has to be paid by the main men that are able to fight. Okay, that's premise number one. Okay.
Whoa, you need to show sources, bro.
Okay.
What you're saying, okay. Premise number one,
yes.
Show sources.
Okay, no problem.
I don't talk without sources.
No problem.
Show me sources. Ali Dawah always talks without sources.
No problem. That's what you do.
95%, I'll give you 5%.
Yeah, no problem.
95%.
We'll let people decide.
Show me sources.
We'll let people decide.
Yeah, okay. We will, but you need to go with your sources.
Everything that I said, I will bring the sources.
Yeah, okay. Back it up.
Okay, barbecue sauce as well. Okay, now, what we're going to do is this here. Why did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wage war on Muslims? Do you know why, Daniel?
Are you asking questions? You're supposed to answer questions.
I am. So what
do you answer questions.
Okay, alright, no problem.
Yeah. Jizya payment. No, it doesn't say humiliation.
No problem. For argument.
You're changing topics now, you know.
No.
If it doesn't say jizya, what is the word? Tell me.
I never said to you. I said the word jizya is not there.
Okay, what is it?
But
read it for me.
Yes, I'm not fluent. Even if the word jizya is there, my problem is that I don't have a problem with the ones who are attacking the Muslims to be humiliated by paying the jizya. I have no problem with that. Zero problem with that.
Yeah, yeah.
So what I'm doing is now... Is
okay, wait. Ali Dawah, before you move on. You said the word jizya is not there. That's what you came here by saying that first.
Yes.
And then now... You are retracking and saying, oh no, the word jizya, for argument's sake, you will be there.
No, it's not there.
It's not there.
It's not there.
So what is the word then? Tell me.
The word is not there.
Okay, jizya is not there.
No.
Do you read Arabic?
No.
I'm saying for that, you need someone to read Arabic and explain it.
No,
he came so confident as if it doesn't say jizya.
It doesn't say
And now he's like, let me read Arabic, but I'm not scholar or I don't read Arabic properly.
The word jizya is not there. This is clear.
Okay, what does it say then? Can you read it for me? What does it say?
Given the translation, but I'm saying it.
No, the Arabic. The Arabic. Can you read the Arabic?
I'm not fluent.
So you're not confident to actually go with this topic.
The word? No. It's a nice try. I know you're trying to step out of it.
Read it for me. What does it say?
The word Jesus doesn't exist.
Okay, read it.
So what we're going to talk about, the premise was, is that are we supposed to humiliate?
Listen, Khalifa means behind. You know the word Arab?
Yeah. No.
Behind.
The premise.
So they will be humiliated by paying behind. Does it make sense?
Say it. Say it. He's using that to digress. Yeah. Let's not do it.
Would you digress?
He's digressing. Yeah. The key here is that are we as Muslims to go to the general Christian and Jews and say we need to humiliate you by paying jizya? This is the crux of the matter. Okay.
Should I read it for you?
Abu Bakr radiallahu an waged war on who? Three types of people. Yeah. The ones who want to pay the zakah. The ones who claim to be a prophet. Yeah. False prophet. Yeah. And the ones who went back. Against their pagan beliefs. Okay, now the question that needs to be asked is this, very simply and very clearly. Okay, why did Abu Bakr radiallahu an wage war on the Muslims for not paying the zakah? The zakah is obligatory. This is a knockout blow. This is very crucial.
Why are you
crucial.
Diverting?
This is very crucial.
Why are you diverting?
Very crucial.
Why are you going to the Muslims?
Come now.
I never talked about it.
Like the sun, he melts the ice cream. Yeah. Now he's.
Ali Dawah, you're
watch
diverting.
Watch this.
Do Muslims pay jizya?
I'm saying no one pays zakah.
Exactly. So why are you talking about Muslims?
So why did Abu Bakr wage war on the Muslims for not paying zakah?
I'm not talking about that. That's a different topic.
No, it's not. Because the whole point here is that there has to be a tax that has to be paid. Yeah. As Muslims, zakah has to be paid by the men. And the woman, and those who reach the age limit. You're gonna feel sorry for yourself.
The sun is hot,
but the arguments are gonna be hotter. Yeah. So now it's gonna be hotter. Watch this. Yeah.
Why are you saying these words? The premise doesn't make it right.
Watch it now. Yeah. So Abu Bakr waged war on the Muslims for not paying zakah. Zakah is something that is obligatory on the Muslim men and women to pay.
Okay.
1 second. Now the jizya is on who? Is on who? When Islam was conquering land, yeah, some of the Christians said, you know what? We don't want to pay jizya. We want to fight with you against them.
Show me the source.
The Christians said we will join you in your forces to fight the enemy. Yes.
Whoa, he's changing topic.
Don't worry.
You're changing your words.
You're not today.
In like 5 seconds.
Yeah. Now,
so hey, Muslims that are listening, if you're embarrassed by him, yeah,
the panic
just say it.
Started.
Because I can see from your faces,
yes.
What he's saying is embarrassing.
No problem.
He's not even sticking with a topic. Ali Dawah, stick with the topic and show me where the Christians joined Muhammad to fight.
I'm going to come to it.
Okay, we don't need your preaching.
So now, how are we going to debunk this? We're going to debunk it one by one, yeah? First is that Abu Bakr waged war on also Muslims who did not pay the zakah. Point number one. So that shows that was Abu Bakr humiliating the Muslims who didn't pay zakah? If he was, so that means that it was not for only the Christians and the Jews who were attacking, but also for the ones who didn't want to pay the jizya, but it was also for the Muslims. So hold on a second. Are you telling me the first Khalifa of Islam waged war on his own brothers to pay the zakah? Yeah, own brothers, and guess what? And sisters for paying the zakah. I thought the humiliation was only for Christians and Jews. Why did the Muslims come into it?
You ranted and ranted Where is your source?
It's here.
Go on, read it then.
So now, what I'm going to do
is... Jizya, not Zakat. Don't read to me about Zakat. Please.
No problem, yeah?
Jizya payment. I'm going to have to shorten this because you're just going on and on.
We need to shorten
it. Yeah, we do. But I'll show you the sources.
I don't blame you. If I was you, I would want to shorten it too. You know, I would want to shorten it very much, actually. You know, it's getting hot, isn't
it? I'm not shortening it.
You want water, we'll get you water, whatever you like.
Because I am losing the debate.
Exactly. Anyways.
Yeah. I am shortening it because you're not fit enough for this debate.
So, no problem. We'll let the people decide. It's like somebody in a boxing ring, he's getting sparked out, and he's like, I can knock you out, but I'm going to leave early because I need to catch the train home, yeah? So now, and I'm not talking about the physical, yeah? So now, this was a knockout blow, I told him. I said, Daniel, don't do this to yourself. Not on a sunny day, don't. And he said to me, next week, Ali, next week. And today is the week. So he said, I need to go. You're not going nowhere, bro. I'm not going to hold you. You can walk. But the question here is this, yeah? Now what we're going to do is, my argument and premise is this. Why did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wage war on the Muslims for the same reason? Answer. Now, let's go to the source, okay?
So he's going to Zakat and Muslims. The debate has nothing to do with Zakat and Muslims. The debate has to do with jizya as a sign of humiliation for Jews and Christians to pay it under Islamic State. Surah 9:28-30, Ibn Kathir, The Battles of the Prophet, page 183 and 184. Sahih al-Bukhari, book 55, chapter 88. I'm giving you your own sources. It says, jizya payments for humiliation. Ali Dawah is going to Zakat. Why? Why are you going to Zakat? I'm not debating you on Zakat. Jizya payment. And I can read it for you over and over again.
Read it.
You won't get it.
Read it.
What do you mean? Which one do you mean?
You asked me for evidence that who is jizya for, yeah? The four schools of imams, this is what they said. There is no jizya on the kids, women, and the insane. This is the view of the four imams. Ibn Munzar said, I do not know anyone to have differed with them. Abu Muhammad ibn Qadama said in Al-Mughni, we do not know of any difference of opinion among the learned on this issue. Now, this is clear cut with the four schools of thought that the jizya is only for the...
Al-Mughni, yeah?
What source is
Al-Mughni?
What do you mean what source?
Give me the source.
This is the source. There is no jizya on the kids, women, and the insane. This is the view of the four imams. This is four schools of thought.
Okay,
yeah?
All of them. Please stay straight. Yeah?
I'm straight.
Jizya, is it for Jews and Christians?
And also the majors.
Sorry?
Yes, and also for the majors. They're different religions.
Okay, Surah 929.
Yes.
Jews and Christians pay jizya for humiliation. Yes.
Yeah? For those who attack.
Stick with that. No, it doesn't say it's also attack.
Yes.
Show me.
Show me
where it says. No, wait. Let's not digress.
Yeah.
Show me where it says when they attack you, then you make them pages.
Okay, good question. Okay,
the debate is going on for 3 weeks, and you guys can't show one evidence.
No, we showed it.
What, they were attacking the
Muslims? No, we showed it. Very simple. For example, the Prophet, peace be upon him, sent a messenger, yeah? A messenger to deliver the message to the Byzantine Empire and the Persian, if I'm not mistaken, yeah? This is a war crime, yeah? This is by default a war crime. The messenger was executed. His head was chopped off. Okay, and this is when the Battle of Mutta happened, if I'm not mistaken. The Prophet, peace be upon him, sent the armies forward, yeah? Now, what's the evidence for this? What's the evidence that the Romans were the ones that were transgressing? Number one, they killed the messenger of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Number two, in Sahih Bukhari, Umar ibn Khattab is said that one day somebody came and started knocking on the door, one of the companions, yeah? So he rushed downstairs and he said, what's going on, yeah? And he rushed out and said to the other companion, he said, what happened? Did the Prophet divorce his wife? He said, no. And he said, oh no, he also said, are the Romans here? No, that's, sorry, I correct myself. He said, are the Romans here? He said, no, worse than that. The Prophet divorced all his wives. So why did he come down in a panic? And when the door was banging, if somebody's after you and someone knocks the door, you're going to come down and be like, yo, are they here to, you know, let me finish. Don't worry.
Yeah, but you're ranting.
No, I'm not ranting.
There's no source.
But it's hurting you.
There's no source.
It's hurting you. I give you the source.
No, the one you're talking about now.
I give you the source.
No, the one you're talking about now, you haven't given it.
So 1 second. So why did Umar ibn Khattab say, did the Romans come? Why? Did he wake up one day and say, I had a dream? Is the Romans here? So, what does that show? the battle of Muta, yes, the battle of Muta and the other battles. Why? Because the Romans were coming to invade the Arabian Peninsula.
Okay, so, fine. That's so, you saying
so,
it.
So,
your source doesn't say that.
No, one second.
I'll read
one second. So, I'm saying very simply and clearly, they were coming to attack. So, therefore, the Surah Tawbah verse 929 came down for what? Humiliate them. Your enemies are going to, look, imagine this, guys. Your enemy is going to come to attack you. Man's got a sword, he's got a gun, he's coming to attack you. And here, I'm going to have a go at you and be like, what's your plan? You're going to be like, bro, I'm going to disarm him, I'm going to defend myself, and I'm going to humiliate him. And I'm going to be like, look at you, you shameless man. How dare you? Shame on you. He's coming to kill you and you're going to humiliate him. You know what? You know what? Yeah? So the question here is this, yeah? Of course, those who are coming to attack us, the least that we can do is humiliate them.
Takiyah.
The least that we can do is humiliate them.
That's why Lizzie wanted to debate on Takiyah.
Okay.
She knew you were going to do the Takiyah.
Okay.
Here.
What's
let me read your source.
What's Takiyah?
I will explain Takiyah. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, divert the topic.
No, I want to read your source.
Read it.
This is Ibn Kathir. I read it twice now. Last week and the week before.
Read it.
Fight those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which has been forbidden by Allah and His Messenger, nor acknowledge the religion of the truth from among the people of the book until they pay the jizya with willing submission and feel themselves subdued. And then Ibn Kathir concludes, therefore, the Messenger of Allah decided to fight the Romans in order to call them to Islam. So the reason why your prophet went to fight the Romans is to call them to Islam. If I am a liar, go and check Ibn Kathir, the battles of the prophet, that's the book's name, page 183 to 184. If I am lying, your source is lying. And we know your sources lie a lot. But you are dependent on your source. Calm down, sir. So, Ali Dawah, I don't want you to divert this topic and try and take somewhere and then the point is washed away. It won't happen with me. Because I'm going to expose you more and more. Ali Dawah, answer questions. Jizya payment is for humiliation. The reason why, I'm not saying Muhammad never fought the Romans, but the reason why he had to fight them was to call them to Islam, according to Ibn Kathir. He is saying the reason why Muhammad went to fight the Romans is because they were attacking him. No, doesn't say that. He's writing his own tafsir. Ali Dawah might have his own Quran, we don't know. If you do, reveal it for us, let's read it.
I'm not Christian, I don't have many Bibles.
32 Quran.
Do you have your own Quran?
We have one Quran.
Okay then, read what your sources say. Your mind says.
Okay.
So can you please stick with the topic and answer questions?
Was it? Didn't Ustad Adnan Rashid debate you on this? Got a person where your camera cut out because your battery died? And debunk you on this claim that it says that the Prophet went to fight them. You got destroyed and humiliated.
As I said to you.
Look, you got humiliated without jizya. You didn't give no jizya and you got humiliated.
As I said to you, the reason why he had to go and fight them was to call them to Islam.
One second.
There's nothing to
hide. One second. Ustad Adnan Rashid had a discussion with him where their cameras cut out. The battery said, you know what, I can't carry on anymore. The battery is dead. This is where we read it in Arabic. Nowhere did it say that the Prophet went to fight them because of this reason. He got humiliated without paying jizya, yeah? No jizya, and he got humiliated. So he's coming here. One second. We got an Arab.
Go and check it.
Look.
What did I say to the guy who was speaking Arabic? What did I say to him?
Let me finish. That's
be consistent. What did
you're
I say to him?
Hurt.
Be consistent then.
It's melting, the jizya argument is melting, yeah? Okay, so the point is this. Ustad Adnan Rashid debunked this guy. He cut this bit out, yeah? Let me tell you something. Why, one second. Do you know that the messenger of the Prophet got executed?
The messenger?
Of the Prophet, yes, by the Romans.
What does that go to do with jizya?
Yeah.
Do you know, yes or no?
What does that go to do with jizya? I'm not going to digress. I'm not going to let you digress this topic.
Did the messenger get killed?
I'm not going to answer that question.
Exactly. No problem. Yes, he got. He got killed by the Romans.
Expert answering.
And that is a way.
That we're not debating on.
If Russia sends an ambassador here, and Theresa May says, slice. Is Russia going to send a bunch of flowers and say,
okay,
UK,
okay,
we love you.
I know you're using that.
Thank you.
Okay,
one second.
Went to fight them.
UK is going to say, fam, that's a declaration of war. Now, when you go to war, I have never seen someone have a fight with roses or throwing kisses at each other like, hey, there you go, and send me back as well.
Okay.
War is war, fam. So in war, war happens.
So you disagree with what you're saying?
I accept that the Jews and the Christians that are hostile.
It doesn't say hostile.
Let me finish. Because if it's not, then there's a contradiction in the Quran. Let me tell you how. Because when we go to Surah Buruj verse 7, Surah Tawbah verse 13, when we go to Surah chapter 60 verse 8, Allah is saying, we do not forbid you from being kind and just to those who do not fight you. Point number one. In Surah Buruj, Allah SWT says that they were the ones who were attacking you first. The same with Surah Tawbah. So hold on a second.
Surah Tawbah doesn't say they were attacking you.
Daniel, come on, listen.
The ayah is very clear. It says, fight those who don't believe in Allah.
Watch this.
That's what the ayah says.
Watch this.
Doesn't say fight those who are attacking you.
Watch this. Seeing is believing. Yeah? We're going to go to Surah Tawbah verse 13. Okay.
Verse 29.
We're going to go there as well. Context. Yeah?
29.
One second.
The context of that starts at 28.
We're trying to look.
Literal context.
Listen, what we're saying is there are Christians that are good and there are Christians that are bad. There are Jews that are good and there's Jews that are bad.
No, you're just,
there's Muslims that are good and there's Muslims that are bad.
So now,
I'm asking you something, and the Quran makes this distinction very clearly in Surah Tawbah verse 13, Surah Buruj verse 7, and Surah chapter 60 verse 8. Because otherwise it's a contradiction. Be kind and just to them, fight them wherever you catch them, kill them. Hold on a second, am I supposed to fight them or be kind to them? So therefore, when someone of understanding will say, hold on a second, there's a context.
Understanding.
For those who are hostile, of course you're going to fight them. And for those that are kind and just to you, you do them with justice.
I guarantee you.
So, now,
if Ali Dawah was in Iraq and Syria, he would say this thing.
Shall I tell you something?
He's in England with his washed down Islam, with his washed down theology of Islam, so he has to cover up the truth. That's Taqiyya.
That's what I told you.
Surah 328.
It sounds like a,
Surah 328.
It sounds like a female.
I'll give you Taqiyya.
Use Taqiyya.
Surah 328.
No.
Surah 328 is for you.
No, I told him.
That's Surah 328. Apply for you.
I told him this is going to be a knockout blow. Daniel, don't do this. He even came, when I said to him, he said, I don't want to debate. I don't blame him. Yeah? So now, I'm saying something very simply. Yeah? One second. I'll say something very simply. Okay. I hope if this guy comes to Islam, ISIS will recruit him like this. They'll be like, fam, you're on the right. You are right. ISIS will say, fam, you need to come and join us. Exactly what you're saying. Kill the disbelievers.
I will never join Islam.
I never.
I've got the truth in Jesus.
I never Islam.
Amen. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life.
I make dua.
He's the only one.
Come on. I pray with this mentality. Uncle, I beg you for the sake of Allah.
Can you not interrupt your brother?
Now, I make prayers that you never join Islam with this mentality, because you go and end up killing bloody innocent Christians and Jews. I hope you do not join Islam with this mentality. I hope you join Islam.
I will never join Islam, man.
I hope.
There's no ground, so I will never join Islam.
Listen.
Never in my life.
ISIS will recruit you.
Concentration.
Listen, brothers, please don't leave. Listen. ISIS will write a letter to Daniel. Daniel, we've been listening to you. Since you've come to Islam, you are the perfect candidate.
Can you imagine?
I just spoke to Abu Bakr Baghdadi. He said, you are a star.
Why would they say that?
Now, you know why?
Because he follows the Quran perfectly.
Because you know why? Because ISIS and this guy, they agree. ISIS says to him, when ISIS watches this thing.
Your Quran agrees with ISIS.
Yeah.
I disagree with ISIS. Because Jesus died for us already. We don't need to die.
We don't even know what to die. ISIS watches. You know when ISIS watches, you know what they do? ISIS is like, Daniel, you go game. You go on. This is the problem. Now, what did I say? The knockout.
This is like primary school.
Why did Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu, wage war on the Muslims for not paying the zakat?
Show me.
So,
now. Oh, zakat. He's got his zakat now.
So, now.
You know what?
Now.
We're going to wrap this up.
Nah, exactly.
Nah, because you are not fit for this debate.
You're like a chicken
wrap
now.
You're not fit, brother.
You're like a chicken wrap. Of course you're going to wrap it up.
You're not fit.
Now, let me add an extra sauce there, yeah? Ketchup, mayonnaise. Let me add it to the wrap. Let me add it to the wrap. One second. Now. I asked him very simply, yeah? Look, Abu Bakr waged war on the Muslims for not paying the zakat. So hold on a second. I thought you only wage war on those who do not believe that are Christian and Jews. Why is he attacking the Muslims? Answer. I told you.
You can't answer that question.
Yeah, of course
it's
you can't.
Diverting.
Fam,
I don't want
to
divert.
What did I say to you?
That's your tactics.
Today is not the same
your
day.
Tactics are diversion.
It's a sunny day, Daniel.
Diversion,
don't
diversion,
do this
diversion.
Daniel, don't do this.
Don't divert.
Listen. He actually was right. He said, I don't want to debate today. I don't blame him. So now you
what
tell
is
me.
The reason?
You tell me. Because it's a problem. Why did
done.
Abu Bakr wage
done.
War on Muslims who didn't pay this account?
I'm not going to talk about zakat. We're talking about jizya. Ali Dawah, for the Muslims.
Jizya.
For the Muslims that just came, Ali Dawah came to me here and he said, the source that you gave last week does not say jizya. I said to him, are you sure? He said, yes. I took out the source and it clearly says humiliation by paying jizya. It clearly says that. I showed it to you. Let me show it to you again. I can't believe this. Okay, I'll show it to you. No problem.
Show me where Arabic says
jizya. And then now he's diverting it to zakat.
Yes.
Because he can't debate the jizya. That's it. It's done and dusted.
Laughing. I wish laughing was a reply. I'll laugh the loudest.
And he's asking me where it says jizya in the Arabic.
Why did Abu Bakr wage war on the
Muslims? When the guy cannot read Arabic himself.
Why they're going to pay every single penny. Why?
Can you read Arabic?
Why?
Can you read Arabic?
Why? Yes, I can.
Exactly. So read this
for me. I'm not going to do anything.
Read this for me then.
Can you speak Hebrew?
Read this for me.
Exactly.
Read this for me.
Show me. I can read in Arabic.
No, I know you. Brother.
Simple question.
Why did Khulafa?
No, I'm asking.
And they said,
why did Abu Bakr wage war on the Muslims for not paying zakat? Why? Why? Why?
We can talk about that at a different time.
At
a different time.
The remix, yeah? Okay.
Jizya is what we're talking about now.
And by the way, guys, the only reason I'm doing this is because I'm humiliating him. You know why? Because he deserves it. He needs humiliation. You know why? Because he's deceitful. He lies.
Unfortunately.
He cuts. He ate this video. Daniel, look.
Right now, you've
you
humiliated
say
yourself.
The Muslim should get jizya and humiliate. I humiliated you without jizya. You got humiliated. We don't even want your jizya. So now, keep your jizya to yourself. Okay, I'm asking a simple question here. The Abu Bakr
under Islamic State.
Wait,
so
look. You know what? That's a real good question. You're not under Islamic State, and I'm not talking about ISIS. Yeah, the bloody scumbags. Yeah, I'm talking about. Let's go and see people who lived under the Islamic rule. What did they say? Have you lived under Islamic rule before?
Do I have to?
Have you ever?
Do I have to?
No, you haven't. Because if you did, you would say, you know what?
Have you?
I love it.
Have
here.
You?
Yeah?
Have you lived under Islamic rule?
Watch this.
Have you lived under Islamic rule? So why are you asking me then? Yeah. This guy is funny, you know? Why are you asking me then?
How many Christians?
What do you mean it's against me? You're a Muslim.
I'm with
a Muslim.
The Islamic rule. You do.
Okay.
Now, let's see.
Under Islamic rule, do Jews and Christians have to pay jizya? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah? Why?
Why? Because they're living under the Islamic State.
Council tax.
But we don't want
to.
No, it's not tax. Don't lie, man. It's got nothing to do with tax.
Yes,
your source. Show me where it says it's tax.
It is.
Show me where it says it's tax.
Brother.
It's not tax at all. Don't lie.
What's it? You have to pay jizya.
For
and
why?
The same
why?
Way, why does the Muslim have to pay zakat?
No, I'm not talking about that. Oh, my Lord.
It's an Islamic obligation. It's in our religion.
Because we don't believe in Allah. That's why we have to pay jizya. Otherwise, kill them.
No.
That's the source of Ibn Kathir, Sahih al-Bukhari, and the Quran.
No problem.
We're going to have to end it.
No problem. No, of course we're going to end it. We ended it already.
It's finished.
Now what we're going to do is, watch this. As you can see, guys, he runs away. Okay. When he knows the crux of the matter, watch this. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to go to the Christians and the Jews that lived in the Islamic State rule, and let's see what they said. He hasn't lived there. He has no experience, man. It's like you saying, I don't want to work. I don't want to work in Primark. Yeah, I have no problem with the Islamic rule. I don't have it. Yeah, you do. So now, guys, listen to this carefully. Yeah, okay. Non-Muslim testimonies. Yeah, Nestorian John Parr Penkaya 690 expressed fascinating sentiments regarding the reign of Muawiyah. Look, the peace. Look at this. This is non-Muslims living in the. Look what they're seeing. The peace throughout the world was such that we have never heard. Did any of them say, "Hey, they killed us so badly"?
Oh my God!
Look.
Which Christians
either from our fathers or from our grandparents, you see, in fam, you know, our ancestors, they didn't even see this kind of peace.
So, Ali Dawah, you're going
to...
It hurts.
Bernard the Wise, the pilgrim monk, visited Egypt and Palestine in the reign of the Khalifa of Al-Mu'taz.
Give us some modern examples.
Look at this. Yeah, it hurts. Well, Allah says in the Quran, when truth comes, false
you're reading.
It melts. The sun is not melting them, it's the argument.
Watch this.
I've got bars. The Christians and the pagans, i.e. the Muslims, have this kind of peace between them that if there was anything going on the journey and on the way the camel or the donkey which bore my luggage was left there and I was to abandon all my goods without any guardian and go to the city for another pack of animal, when I came back, I would find all my property uninjured. Such is the peace there. Somebody who hasn't lived there, somebody who's lived there. Somebody who hasn't lived there, somebody who's lived there.
Brother,
then why do you believe me when I say janazah?
Can I talk?
You just buried yourself.
I asked Ali Dawah to read his sources earlier on. Yeah? Bukhari, Kathir, Quran. He is an expert in reading for me, those who lived under Islamic rule, but he can't read his original text to prove his claim. Secondly, he's reading to me those who have disobeyed Muhammad. They've already disobeyed Muhammad by not like making the Jews and the Christians pay jizya for humiliation. And he's reading a rule that they've disobeyed Muhammad already. Because the Quran is clear. Jizya payment is for humiliation. Clear, because we don't believe in Allah. If they don't believe, what do you do to them?
Naughty, naughty.
Kill them.
Naughty, naughty.
Very clear. Jesus Christ never says kill anyone. He says love your enemies. Pray for those who despitefully use you.
Amen.
Pray for those who persecute
Amen.
You. Very clear.
When I can't, Jesus, when we can't answer, Jesus, stop preaching.
Don't come to lies of Muhammad.
Amen.
Come to Jesus,
yes.
Who's the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes.
I'm out. Finished.